Okay, so this is going to be hopefully a pretty quick one. Today we're going to look at how you can use core supported tooling to either add multiple blocks easily to a single brand new plugin, or take an existing plugin and add more than one block to it if you already had one block, and have it compile beautifully and work lovely, and it's going to be awesome. So let's go. Okay, so WordPress has this handy little library, this tool, I guess, that is called Create Block. And if you run this, it actually will create a plugin for you, and it'll add a block, and everything is just installed, and all the tooling is there, and you're given some commands, and boom, you're off and running. So we are going to use that to create the initial plugin for a brand new plugin, and have it also create that first block. Okay, so in quick start, it tells us the command is npx, we're at WordPress create block, and then the slug of what the plugin and the block will be. So I'm going to grab this, and we'll go back into VS Code, and here I'm in the plugins directory of the current WordPress installation. And I'm going to pop that in there, and we're going to call it UrbaBlocks, because why not? Now it's going to download all the things and install all the things and compile all the things, and sometimes it takes a couple minutes. Ta-da! Block UrbaBlocks has been bootstrapped into the UrbaBlocks folder, which is our plugin. So now, if I go into our WordPress installation and go into plugins, there is a brand new block plugin called UrbaBlocks. Let's activate it. Then we pop into a post, and if I go into the block library, there it is, UrbaBlocks, with the infamous smiley face. But we want more than one block in here, so let's make that happen too. Here I'm gonna pull the terminal over to the one side where I usually have it, and it's a little too small. Okay, and let's show our files. Here we're going to go into UrbaBlocks right here and open up the source folder. And the first thing I'm going to do is going to make a new folder where my first block is going to live. So we're going to call it block A. And let's take all of these other files that were in source and pop them in here. So everything should be inside this folder. Then we're going to duplicate that folder and call it block B. Boom. All right. So now we have block A and block B, but right now they're both called UrbaBlocks. So let us fix that. So I'm going to grab this term UrbaBlocks, and here I'm going to look for UrbaBlocks, but only inside the source block A folder first. Okay. And I'm going to replace it with block A, like so. And then I'm going to do this, but it's going to be UrbaBlocks for the full title name, and replace that with block A. Do that. And then we'll do the same thing for block B. Change that to block B. And then UrbaBlocks with a hyphen, and block B like so. Replace that. And all our files are replaced now. And now in the terminal, I'm gonna pop into, let's make that a little bigger. I'm gonna pop into UrbaBlocks. We're gonna run npm start to compile. And when we compile, in the build folder, you'll see there's actually a block A folder and a block B folder. You're not just seeing those files that you used to have before. And if you open this up, you'll see everything else in there, including the block.json file, which means you no longer have to reference anything outside of the build folder when you're registering your block. So now we can go into the main plugin file, and here where it says register block type, we're actually going to make this say block A like so, and then copy it to be block B. And we'll save that. And now if I refresh this, this would actually tell me that it doesn't support this block. And instead in block library, we will see two new blocks. Let's go. Okay. So I refreshed it and this isn't supported anymore. And if I open this up, there is now block A and block B, like so. Ta-da! It's actually really easy, and I ended up making a little sort of starter folder for myself that I can use when I'm making a brand new plugin that needs to have multiple blocks and it's all just ready to go. But honestly, it's as simple as popping into a plugin that you already have WordPress scripts or WP scripts installed in, and in the source folder, make two folders, okay? And put all the block stuff inside it, including block.json. And the important part is that in block.json, the editor script and the editor style and the style, it all needs to be relative, right? So you're not actually linking to the build folder here. You're saying, hey, in this same folder where I block.json live, you will also find index.js, index.css, and style index.css. Because this is true. It's not true in the source folder, but it is true when it gets compiled, because as you can see, it's all there together. So WP Scripts now supports this out of the box. You don't have to do anything special, no weird extra, you know, entry area through Webpack that you need to provide. It's just going to detect multiple folders, or rather it detects multiple block.json files, and it just does everything accordingly. Just remember to update in your main plugin file the path to register those multiple blocks. And there you go. Hope that helps.